Hello, welcome to Bite Size Med. This video is on the different fibers of connective tissue. Connective tissue is tissue that supports other tissue. It also anchors, binds, and, well, connects cells, tissues, and organs. Depending on its location, it's got cells and an extracellular matrix. The extracellular matrix is ground substance with embedded protein fibers. So connective tissue has cells, fibers, and ground substance. The fibers are made up of proteins, and there are three main types: collagen, reticulin, and elastin. Of these, the most abundant is collagen, making it the most abundant protein in the body. It's important for tensile strength and support. Reticulin is basically a type of collagen, just finer and more delicate. Elastin is stretchy, it's elastic, it can stretch and return to its original shape, elasticity. These three distribute differently in different connective tissue, depending upon where that tissue is located and what its function is. Let's first look at collagen, and that's what majority of this video is on. There are lots of different types of collagen, around 28. Now they can form fibers, sheets, or networks. Their main function is to support and to resist the forces acting on these structures. Though there are many types, most collagen belongs to type 1 to 4. So we're expected to know some of the areas where those four types are located. The most abundant type is type 1 collagen. Some areas where you'd find type 1 collagen is in bone, tendons, and the dermis of skin. Bone, it's got a 1 in it. That's how usually everyone remembers it. Bone has type 1 collagen. And bone is usually followed everywhere by cartilage. So type 2 collagen is in cartilage. Two other areas with type 2 collagen would be the vitreous humor of the eye and the nucleus pulposus of the intervertebral disc. Type 3 collagen is actually reticular fibers. These are seen in organs that usually form a part of the reticuloendothelial system: the connective tissue of the spleen, the liver, lymph nodes, bone marrow. They have reticular fibers, and it forms reticular connective tissue. Unlike the other types of collagen, it is finer and more delicate. It also stains black with silver impregnation on tissue sections, making it argyrophilic. Type 4 collagen forms the floor of the epithelial cells, the basement membrane, or the basal lamina of the basement membrane. Type 4 collagen forms the floor. It's also found in the lens of the eye. So that's type 1, 2, 3, and 4. But remember, there are lots of different types of collagen with different locations and different functions. For example, type 7 collagen forms anchoring fibrils in the basement membrane. These three, that's type 1 to 3, they form fibrils. Thus, they are fibril-forming collagens. But type 4 forms networks or sheets. So not all types of collagen forms fibers and bundles. The most studied collagen is type 1, and it does form fibrils. Collagen is a protein, so it's got polypeptide chains. There are three chains, alpha chains, that form a triple helix. Collagen thus has a triple helical structure. Each chain has amino acids, and they form a unique triple repeating sequence, a set of three, and each set has glycine. So glycine repeats once in three amino acids. Three amino acids, so glycine X and Y on repeat. X and Y could be any amino acid, but the two amino acids that usually appear in collagen are proline and lysine. This protein has to be synthesized, and that happens usually in the fibroblast. Remember that connective tissue has cells and fibers and ground substance. Fibroblasts are the cells that synthesize the proteins that then form the fibers and ground substance. The initial steps of synthesis are similar to any protein synthesis: transcription and translation. Here's the nucleus. Transcription forms messenger RNA, which is then followed by translation in ribosomes. That forms a peptide chain, with a leader sequence called a signal peptide. This is pre-procollagen, and that signal peptide guides the peptide chain into the cisternae of the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Now enzymes remove the peptide sequence. This is procollagen. In the rough endoplasmic reticulum, procollagen undergoes a lot of post-translational modifications. The central domain has those three amino acids on repeat, glycine, X, and Y. The accompanying amino acids to glycine are usually proline and lysine. Some of them get hydroxylated. Proline to hydroxyproline and lysine to hydroxylysine. The addition of a hydroxyl group is biprolyl hydroxylase and lysyl hydroxylase. This process of hydroxylation needs cofactors like iron and vitamin C or ascorbic acid. An application here is in scurvy, where there's a deficiency of vitamin C. Hydroxylation is required because hydroxyproline provides strength to collagen. So in scurvy, weaker collagen results in fragile capillaries, bleeding manifestations, and poor wound healing. Because one of the cofactors needed for hydroxylation is vitamin C. Now that hydroxylation is done, the hydroxylysine residues can also undergo glycosylation, addition of galactosyl and glucosyl units to hydroxylysine. Hydroxylation and glycosylation, these are the two main post-translational modifications in the rough endoplasmic reticulum. The peptide chain has an amino terminal and a carboxy terminal end. The ends of the chains don't have the triple repeat sequences, and those are needed to form the helix. The central domain has the repeats. The ends are stabilized by disulfide bonds. Starting at the C-terminal end, the three polypeptide chains align and fold, forming a triple helix. So we have the central triple helix and the N and C-terminal ends. This trimeric procollagen gets transported to the Golgi apparatus, where it gets packaged into vesicles and secreted. These vesicles are transported by the cytoskeleton to undergo exocytosis, so procollagen gets released into the extracellular space. Outside the cell, there are peptidases, procollagen peptidases, which cleave the ends. So they cut off the ends, leaving behind a triple helix, which is now an insoluble tropocollagen, a monomeric unit of collagen. They spontaneously assemble into collagen fibrils in a staggered alignment. That results in areas of complete overlap and areas with gaps, giving the fibrils a banded appearance. But it's still not completely stable yet. There are covalent crosslinks that form by an enzyme lysyl oxidase. These links stabilize collagen. This enzyme is copper dependent. But now collagen has been synthesized and it's arranged in fibers and bundles. Collagen also undergoes slow turnover in the body. In some areas, like the tendons, it's more stable, but in other areas, renewal happens. That's how tissue repair happens. But for that, collagen first gets broken down by collagenases, which are matrix metalloproteinases. They break collagen down into its protein components. And this group of enzymes is important during remodeling and tissue repair. So we've done collagen and reticulin. Elastin, we're just going to compare it to collagen. Functionally, it's more for elasticity, stretch, and return to its original shape. Where would that be important? The lungs, the elastic arteries, elastic ligaments, and the dermis of skin. That's why pinched skin returns to its original state, elastin fibers in the dermis. Again, it's synthesized in fibroblasts. The precursor is tropoelastin, which forms elastin. And elastin deposits on microfibrils, which form a scaffold. These microfibrils are made up of fibrillins, and there are three types. Mostly is type 1, and a little application here is that a gene defect for fibrillin type 1 can result in Marfan syndrome. Elastin does not have the triple helical structure that collagen has. Elastin also doesn't have the repeating sequence of amino acids. It has got glycine, valine, proline, and alanine, but just not that glycine XY sequence that we saw in collagen. They do develop cross-links by lysyl oxidase, but they're different than collagen. These are called desmosin cross-links, and they are unique to elastin. Collagen gets broken down by collagenases. Instead for elastin, it's elastases. That's the enzyme that can break down elastin. And those are a few things about elastin. Together with collagen and reticulin, they're all the protein fibers of connective tissue. I do hope this video was helpful. If it was, you can give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.